Hi folks, Will from MinIO here, and in this video, we're going to be talking about some of the monitoring features that are available in your MinIO console. Let's take a look. We're going to get into the metrics and logs and watches. We're going to get into some details on metrics as well when we show you how to export to Prometheus and get that information back in so you can see even more detail in your MinIO console. And then I'm going to talk very briefly about Subnet. That's our subscriber network that allows us to reach in and help you out whenever you have a problem with your MinIO cluster. Let's go ahead and take a look. So starting off first, we'll talk about our metrics and our logs and our watches. And these are all built into the console. They are available to you the minute you fire up MinIO. With your metrics, MinIO displays a point in time metric directly in the console. There is no history provided by default, but we'll show you how you can get some more history there. You can also get some details about the drives, and you can get some details about what your drives are doing, including if there's a healing process going on or something along those lines. Let's take a look at that in the browser. So here in our console, you can see here are the metrics that I get. I have one server online. It's got one drive, very simple server, not a lot going on here. But this will show me point in time what's going on. Now these other tabs, usage and traffic and resources, those get enabled when you have configured Prometheus or another tool to keep your history of your MinIO console metrics. So we'll see that in just a little bit. But you also have access to this drives area here, which shows us everything that's going on. If I have a bucket in my system, I can select a particular bucket. I can look at what's going on with that particular set of objects or whatever. And this allows me to see everything that's going on with my drives. Now, in my case, I don't have a lot going on here, so there's nothing really to see. But you can see everything that's happening on your system from the get-go. All of this stuff is available the moment you fire up your MinIO console. MinIO also has a lot of support for the logs. You can get a log error history running right in your console. You can see audit logs. This does require a little extra setup, but you can see audit logs. And you can actually also do a live trace of all of the activity that's happening on the cluster. This is not something you want to leave on all the time, but if you've got something going on, you might want to turn on the trace so that you can see if there's a lot of downloads or uploads happening, something along those lines. So this is all very simple to use. It's all very simple, straightforward, out of the box, ready to go. The last section of our out-of-the-box monitoring involves watches. Now, what a watch is, it allows you to put a trigger on an S3 event. And anytime that S3 event happens, it's going to fire an event to a webhook that you register with the system. Now, you can set up these events to be watched at the bucket level. You can go down to a prefix in the bucket. You can even put a suffix. So if I'm looking for maybe just image files to happen and I want to do some external processing or something like that, I can look at that using these watches. You can also set something up site-wide, so maybe you want to check and make sure if anybody's uploading anything anywhere. You can put a trigger on that as well to make sure that you're seeing those whenever it happens. Very easy to use. You just need to set up the webhooks to deal with the events as they happen. Let's talk about exporting to Prometheus. One of the things I mentioned when we were looking at our metrics view was that there were a few tabs that were not enabled yet. In order to enable those, you have to set up an external tool that's going to come in, scrape the metrics, and store them in its own database. We are fully compatible with Prometheus, so anything that works with the Prometheus format will work, or you can just use Prometheus itself. It's open source, it's really easy to use. So let me show you how we can actually export our metrics to Prometheus and get even more detail about what's happening in our system. So really what we're enabling here is getting that history into our MinIO display. So MinIO is going to export in Prometheus format, and then if you have any system that works with Prometheus already, you can actually just use that to get the details. This allows you to have very detailed reporting inside the MinIO console of what's actually going on with your system. In order to do this, you obviously need to have a functional Prometheus install already. You can run a very simple command, mcadmin prometheus generate, and then the alias of your cluster. This will provide a token for authentication and a scrape config, which you can add to your Prometheus config. Once you have added to the Prometheus config, you just restart Prometheus and everything should be working great. So that's how you get the data out of MinIO and into Prometheus. How do you get it back? Well, once you have Prometheus running and it's got a job ID, all you need to do is tell MinIO, using a couple of environment variables, where the Prometheus server is residing and what the Prometheus job ID is. Once you have that done, you're set. Now, the Prometheus job ID, easy enough, it's in the scrape config. You can obviously change that to whatever you want it to be, but there is a default one. It's MinIO job that is available to you immediately once you've got this set up. Our subscriber network, our subnet integration, also very easy to use. It's a very powerful tool. It's not required to run things, but if you want our support, it's the best way to get support. So it's not monitoring, but it is our central repository. You can register your clusters as needed, as desired. You don't have to register a cluster to run it. The cluster I'm running right now is not registered. But it does allow our MinIO engineers to assist with troubleshooting, and it can allow us to see metrics and diagnostics as needed very easily without us having to come into your system and look. This also enables our health check tool, which is available under our monitoring as well. Once you've registered your cluster with Subnet, there are a few commands that you can use to upload diagnostics and other performance details. They're listed here on the screen. MC support is really the key. So if you do an MC support help in your system, it'll show you all the different things that you can do to send details up to Subnet. By the way, if your system is air-gapped for any reason, there's a number of reasons why you might want to have your system not available on the internet. You can use the air-gap command, which will produce a file, which you can then upload yourself to Subnet using your account. I hope you've enjoyed this overview of some of the ways that you can monitor your MinIO cluster. If you'd like to reach out with us, you can use any of the methods you see here on the screen. If you'd like to chat with us interactively, you can do so on slack.min.io, or you can just leave a comment here on the video. In our next video, I'm going to show you a little presentation on how you can actually set up Prometheus with a running server. We'll see you for the next one.